was bought at P.B. Carroll's for $3.49, 1971. Well, hello. Today we're going to do a restoration on an original 1971 Sizzler car. It was bought at P.B. Carroll's for $3.49, 1971. A little cube. Take care of that. As you can see, it looks pretty good. Got a sealed base on it. So we're going to cut that seal, take it apart, try to get it running. Right now it doesn't run. All right, let's see if I can do this. Trying to break the melted seal on there. Let's see what we got inside. Ew. Okay, next step, we're gonna try to clean this out. Okay, next we're going to prep a little lime away. Set that right here. This is the bottle I bought. Okay, so I am going to remove the wheels. Really decent shape. Set them aside. Nice. This one's got a little bit missing. I'm going to remove the battery. Dispose of that. I don't need to keep that. Yeah, watch that sucker bubble. Got to get rid of all the battery acid. Might as well do a couple at the same time, right? Well, that's all fermenting in there. We're gonna have to clean this body out a little bit. It's got battery acid in it too. Usually the first thing I take out is the little spongy part. These just pull right out. It is a little tricky to work this out of the grill area, but not bad. Just continue cleaning real gentle until I get all that junk out of there. Alright, mostly with soap and water, I got a lot of it out of there. But you gotta be really careful that you don't get these decals wet on the outside. They're paper. You see, I rubbed across this a little bit and it's taken it off some. Just clean it up best you can. And move to the next thing. Alright, these things you can kind of see it's taking a lot of the green off them. Here's the first one. Now, this motor didn't even move at first, now it does. So we'll go ahead and pop the motor out. Work on that separate. This one's still got lots of junk on it. Just take a scrubby brush . Try to scrub these out a little bit . Now you see these pins right here . Those come off . You kind of can't run the motor no more off the battery, so we're going to try to save those. Copper again. All the little connectors are still on. We lost one. Lost one connector. Alright, next we're going to work on the motor. And I've got this, this is what you'd run the cars with. You charge the battery. Pushing this button, plugging it in. We're going to use it as a tester. Oops. So the first thing, you test them by crossing it like this. This one is not running. Well, this is not the right motor. This is the Fat Daddy motor. The motor for it. It doesn't run either. It does move freely, but it doesn't run. So we're going to take it apart and get it running. All right, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to clean up these little posts here. They have to have good electrical connection in order to work. And those two little hairs that are sticking off are what would go on the shaft to make the connection to spin the rotor. Alright, what we gotta do now is two little hairs here. You gotta push one behind that little pin. There's a little holder there. Alright, so there's two little holders. I can't see what I'm doing. All right, make sure the little holders are back. Stupid thing. It's this. Alright. Test it. It doesn't work because I gotta poke these little pins in. That'll release the little hairs in there to touch. That always should work. Well, I hear it doing something, but it's not spinning. There it goes. Well, now that we know the motor works, we'll just put this back together. Car. Let's go get the top.
All right,
Snap the rest in. Now we have ourselves a working sizzler car. Even looks nice. Alright, thanks for watching.